inside there. Pole position for Harry Chapman. Further back, on the outside of row two, David Park. And on the inside of him, there is Chris Snowden. Well, all of these drivers trying desperately to make sure they can get into the final race of the weekend. It is the Sports 2000 Quick Power Festival final. And there is Mira. We just heard from her a moment or two ago. And also there on the grid, Peter Kirkcaldy. Now, Peter has a real challenge for himself because he occupies seventh position on the grid. I remind you again, it's just the top six that go through. Let's hear from Peter about his challenge that lies ahead.
Tough race indeed. Eight laps ahead of us. The last chance for the top six drivers to go through to the final. The drivers now focus on the lighting gantry. The engine notes will rise as the lights go to red. Who's going to make the best of the starts? He's go now. Slow start by Andy Giles there. A good start by Chris Snowden in the self-built CSR01. But right around the outside though, there, a very good start being made by Mike Dodd. He tries to get the lead as they dive down towards Paddock Hill Bend for the first time. They scrabble their way through and now make the run uphill. Andy Giles coming under real pressure. Side by side they arrive now in the braking area for Druids. And it's David Park, in fairness to him, that's gone right around the outside of the lot of them. And Park leads at Druids.
That's an absolutely awesome start there from David Park. He got it off the line. He started in fourth on the grid, remember. He's got round the outside there of Harry Chapman on the run-up to Druids. And Chapman must have been caught somewhat unawares, but he's got to the inside this time as they come into Surtees. And Harry Chapman will retake the lead from David. And so everybody else making their way through there. Further back is Tony Long in the 29. Behind him in 42, remember, the man who spun off into the gravel trap, Lawrence Phillips. And Phillips really with a fair amount to do from there. But of course, they are talking about fighting for sixth position. And at the moment, further back there, that's occupied by Andy Giles.
Look at this though, three abreast coming over the line. Great effort being made there, right around the outside again, Mike Dodd. And now he tries to get past Chris Snowden as well. Snowden in one of the current 2001 spec cars, but even he can't fend off the flying car there of Mike Dodd. The Swift DB2 goes through up into second place. And former Alfa Romeo expert Chris Snowden there in third place. He's built this car himself, the CSR01. He's doing a great job in it. He's still got plans to go back into racing Alphas before long. But Snowden third as they come through the hill. That'll do him. That's good enough to keep him in the race. There's contact there. Teddy Roger dives at the inside. Clubbers a car, sits in the middle of the road, and wallop! Gets hit very heavily indeed there. Well, you can see that Sports 2000 cars are strong. All that bodywork tends to self-destruct on impact, and that Paul was a pretty big impact.
Yeah, Tony Long got sideways there. He was tapped into that, and Mira Firebend in the orange car. Well, Mira, we can see, starting to get out, and red flags, David. No surprise there, really. Here's what happened. Tony Long down the inside, on the outside there, Lawrence Phillips. Contact between the two, and that rotates through 180 degrees, Tony Long. Mira Firebend with nowhere to go. Bang!
She very nearly avoided him. It was the front corners, wasn't it, rather than a head-on impact. The car briefly airborne, so the race being stopped. Of course, everybody now has to make their way past the incident zone. There on the inside, you can see again. I'm not entirely sure there was a gap big enough for him, but it was a very heavy impact, but the two drivers are okay.
And that is a testimony to these Sports 2000 cars. Well, as you can see, they've already recovered Mira's car back into the pit lane, and some substantial damage there, but we're back for the restart.
So another eight laps, the lights get agreed. Now let's see this time whether David Park can make one of his brilliant starts. No, he can't, because this time Harry Chapman and Andy Giles have got wise to it. So David Park trapped mid-grid as they dive down towards Paddock, and this time Andy Giles makes a much better start.
Yeah, Harry Sherrod got a good start too then, 35, he's up to third place, but Andy Giles side by side with Harry Chapman, and Giles will lead. And also going around the outside there, Chris Snowden makes a better fist of it this time. You have to feel, David, though, for the man back there in fifth place at the moment, David Park. He got such a fantastic start in that opening foray into this last chance final, but side by side the leaders.
Chris Snowden trying to get around on the outside there. They're going to be three abreast, are they? Coming along Cooper Strait, because on the inside line now, Harry Chapman tries to go through and he's got the lead. Chris Snowden hung out to dry on the outside line there. Snowden drops back into third place. It was a brave effort. David Park still trying to work his way through as well. Park has a look on the inside line there. Coming up now through clearways on towards Clark Curve. The race leader then now is Harry Chapman. A very brave manoeuvre that was. Chris Snowden drops down into second place, and then third, Harry Sherrod, as they come across the line. And Andy Giles has lost out on this lap as well. Mike Dodd up and past him.
And a real battle going on further back. Lawrence Phillips also side by side there in sixth and seventh place. And in fact, Phillips it is who gets in. He gets ahead of Davey Park. So Davey Park back in seventh. That's just where you don't want to be. But up the hill, the leaders come side by side again. Andy Giles to the inside of him. Lawrence Phillips. Lawrence Phillips, a man on a mission at the moment. And also following through there, Guy Woodward.
That's right, Guy Woodward, former clubman's champion, the solicitor, making good progress now. Of course, he had all sorts of dramas in his heat. What he desperately needs, though, is to be up into the top six. He's looking for gaining a place on the inside, and he's done it, yes, past Andy Giles, seemingly from a long way back. Guy Woodward dives through. There's a spin behind somebody off there, Paul.
Yeah, that's the 49 car, and that is desperate misfortune there. Well, dear, oh dear, Peter Kirkcaldy lost it. We heard from him before. He said it was a technical track and he was struggling to get to grips with it in certain places. But, well, that's disappointing for him. He's still actually stuck over there at McLaren.
Now, Chris Snowden looking for a way there through on the inside once again, and Mike Dodd. Mike Dodd making good progress, though, up through the field. The Marshals quickly on the scene to remove Peter Kirkcaldy's Tiger. That is out of harm's way. So it's the Lola in the lead, the Crosley in second place, but only just.
Into the final stages then, and this is what it's all about. There, further back, David Park. Well, David needs to try and get ahead of Guy Woodward, side by side. Oh, and up the inside! Mike Dodd trying to squeeze his way through there into second place, but it's the two Harrys as they come towards the chequered flag this time. Remember, it's all about who finishes sixth at the moment. That's occupied by Guy Woodward, but also trying to get on terms with him there is David Park. The two Harrys cross the line. Oh, and the sixth position goes to Guy Woodward. Harry Chapman takes the victory ahead of Harry Sherrod. Mike Dodd in third with Chris Snowden in fourth and Lawrence Phillips fifth. But sixth place man and the last slot on the grid for Guy Woodward.
Mira, I've got to ask you what exactly happened there. Well, Tony Long spun and I'm coming down into Graham Hill Bend trying to avoid him. But on the left-hand side, as you're trying to slow down, it's very slippery there. So there was no way I could keep away from him.
All of a sudden, Mira was coming straight at me, so didn't really have anywhere to go.
You okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. Just got a bit of a strain on my shoulder from the seatbelt, which is, you know, what it's there for, but yeah, I'm fine.
I want all the war. Send the word.